we go. I just put out my Battle Slam build, and I did a pretty bad job on the video. I was in a hurry. I know that. I knew that when I was uploading it. I just didn't have the time, and I wanted to show you guys the changes I was making. I like to keep you guys as up-to-date as I am with what I know. Like I said, I've been out of the game for a while, so when I came back and I started running skirmishes, started running dungeons again, I just was getting so frustrated with the amount of time I wasn't using my marked targets. And I use Slam all the time, and I noticed when I was going through feats, because I just started thinking, you know, it's been a while, I should check it all out. And I started noticing that Battle Fury and Slam both have huge buffs in here that we're not using. Now, this is because we were using these down here prior. Alright, this one here was purely to get to this one. Now, 15 damage to mark targets is great, but if you're not able to hit your Indomitable Strike, you're not able to mark with Daring Shout because you're using Battle Fury, you don't have a Guardian Fighter, you're not getting the mark, so it's wasted. You're wasting 10 feat points. I mean, you only get, what, 41 or 61? You're wasting 10? I mean, that's crazy. So, a good idea would be to use another loadout. Those are 500 Zen on the market. Now, you could just buy another loadout and have both builds at the same time. Now, me personally, I just got rid of the other build because I'm not using the mark. So, I'm using Battle Fury constantly, using Slam constantly. Basically, what Slam does once you buff it like this is it gives you a Ring of Brutality. +8, you know, +9. It's much more than the Ring of Brutality is. So, and it's longer. It runs for 10 seconds. Maybe a little more. But, alright, let's just get right into it here. And I will start off showing you guys what we got for our stats. Now, when you're rolling your original stats, you definitely want to roll. So, you get a 12, 12, 12. I think you can get a 10, 10, 10, actually. I'm not sure, but you want to get your intelligence, wisdom, and charisma at the lowest possible rolls. Now, that will leave your strength, dexterity, and constitution at the highest possible rolls. And then, you just stick them all into strength and dex. We're not using constitution. I mean, resistant and ignored is great. We're going to get some of that out of our feats anyway. And you get the critical chance, you get the deflection chance. So, you're getting some of the stuff we lost anyway. We lost the, you know, so... this is just what I do. This is a common thing for great weapon fighters. So we're going to leave that there. That's still from the old build. As you can see, my gear is still, from 8 months ago. Still works fine, you know, in all the runs. I am seeing the updated gear and, you know, it looks pretty good and I'm definitely working towards it. So I will let you guys know when that comes out. Now the River District's the best place to farm right now. There are some Fey weapons. And I'll bring a video out on those here in a bit to show you the best Great Weapon Fighter Fey weapons from the River District from 11.5 mod. So, it's going to be the same as before. You're going to use Sure Strike. You're going to use Destroyer. You're going to use Slam. Weapon Master. Now, I have Daring Shout all the four because I can afford it. I'm still not even using 9 points, so... there's still times I might want to use it, but probably not now that I don't mark targets. So I just did it kind of out of habit. You just got a lot of wasted points as a great weapon fighter, so that's not necessary in this build. Now, Weapon Master Strike 4, Battle Fury 4, Indomitable, Crescendo. Crescendo is still your single mark target attack. Now, don't often use it, and going to use it a lot less more often than I had before because of Slam giving me such a buff, but and there will still be times that I will use Crescendo as a second daily. And in fact, I'm going to look through the other dailies and start trying to see if there might be a better replacement for Crescendo, because Slam's just kind of taking over what it was doing before. So then you got your Hidden Daggers, which buffs you like crazy for your damage buff. So you want to throw those before you start hitting anybody, for sure. If you guys want a rotation video, I can do it. I know Al's Random Kill has a good rotation video, kind of why I never made one. It's a very simple video, but I'll put one out here soon. Now let's get into the feats here. So we're going to be hitting three in the top one, okay? Now, you can, in fact, put four there if you wanted to. But I wanted a little bit more max hit points because I lost some. So, you go three into Disciple of Strength, three into Unstoppable Action, and one into Toughness. Like I said, you can put your toughness up here. That's personal preference, how much health you have. If you're at a lower level, you might want to go towards a little more health at that time and respec later. Now, in your second heroic, you get the Endless Assault, which gives you 6% more damage with your encounters, and that is Endless Assault. Now, the next row we got here is Steely Defense. Grants you power equal to 20% of your defense when it's at 5. I highly recommend, and I think everybody should be having 5 in there. Now, critical severity, obviously, 3. Critical chance, I mean, what the heck is 2% critical chance? Nothing really, so. Yeah, I almost actually thought about putting it down here and getting 10% combat advantage resistance, but I just stuck with the critical chance. Now, increase your damage of your at-will powers by 10. You put 5 in there. That's great weapon focus. That's your first row. You put 5 to Disciple of War, 5 to Staying Power. Now, these are for your Weapon Master Strike, Mitigation. This is gives you power equal to your Recovering Armor Pin. So we're stacking power like crazy in this build. Should be something you're doing as a great weapon fighter anyways. But this part of the build is focused very much on power and critical chance. It's still a very high part of it, but power is very focused. Now we got Focus Destroyer. Now these are ones that we used before. Oh, I skipped over these though. Okay, so we got Disciple of War, we got Stained Power, you skip the next one, then you got your fourth in your Destroyer Paragon. Executioner Style, that's your Indomitable Battle Strike and Sure Strike. It's awesome, you can use that all the time. Reduces the cooldown of Roar, Takedown, Battle Fury by 50%. The damage of Roar and Takedown are increased by 25%. And the duration of Battle Fury is increased by 25%. That means that you are going to be just, your action points are going to be gaining faster. It's going to be, it's very useful if you're running Battle Fury. Especially since Battle Fury was taking, I think, 17 second cooldown. Drops down to like 11 or 12 after you do this. So that's a huge advantage right there. Focused Destroyer. All right, that is going to be 5 into there. Destroyer has a 25% chance of grant stacking when hitting a number of targets. Additionally, Destroyer grants you 3.5% bonus damage per stack. Destroyer, like I said, is one of your passive abilities that you're using in your powers, so that's a huge one. And then here's the Slam Advancement. All right, so Savage Advance grants you 25% shorter cooldown for 15 seconds, and Slam grants you 25% more power while activated. Now, like I said, if you're sitting at, okay, when I got everything procced, I'm going hard, it's like 30,000 power I sit at, 30 to 32, right? So 25% of that is going to be close to 7,500 for 10 seconds. So you're increasing, like I said, by like a Ring of Brutality plus 8. It's a huge thing, and it's not worth, like I said, unless you're running strictly your best friend's a guardian fighter, you guys run dungeons every day, you're running Daring Shout on your own, there's no reason to run this anymore. And this was just to get you to this anyway. So these were just wasted 5 points, and then 5 points you use 10% of the time. It's just ridiculous. You know, I never claimed to make my own build prior. It was a common build used, and I had so many people asking me, what build? You sit there and walk people through respecing over and over until my entire game playing time was focused on helping other people, not ever getting to do anything for myself. So that's when I put up my original videos, was just to be like, hey man, just go watch the video, all the feats are up there. And you know, people come on, oh, this is Leon Knowles' build. That's great, man. I never claimed to have invented the build. I claimed to use it, help people out, show the community. Not everybody goes on Reddit, not everybody knows who Leon Knowles is, but when you type in Great Weapon Fighter DPS, my video comes up. That's all I was trying to do was help. There was never any other way of looking at it besides just helping out and being able to get my own game time in. So you need to pause the video or fast forward through all my talking. Here's all your feats. Now your boons, they are all very self-explanatory unless you're a very new player. You got your defense. Your guild stronghold's gonna be whatever your guild has or doesn't have. Sharandar, we're gonna be hitting 400 power, 400 crit, 3% action points. That gives you your slam 3% faster. When striking a foe, you get a chance to deal 20,000 arcane damage. Now I thought about using this one because I don't know how much that procs, but I went with it anyway because it does damage instead of healing, which is great. When you kill a foe, you gain 135 power for 45 seconds. This buff stacks up to 30 times. Holy crap, right? I mean, that one's great. That's why I went through the Sharandar campaign as fast as I could. One of the few that I ran through, and the Maze Engine. 250 power, 400 lifesteal, over 400 regeneration. You can kind of, I guess, choose your own there. I prefer lifesteal. 3% resistance ignored, much better, because that is, that's what you need to go. When taking damage, you have a chance to, okay, so I did swap one, because the Shadow Touch, I didn't really care for. I mean, 20,000 necrotic damage over a few seconds after this effect ends, the receives 25% less healing from spells for 10 seconds. Now, what enemy do you fight that need to receive 25% less healing? That seems more like a PvP deal. So I took a little bit of extra healing since I did lose a little bit of health by not going 3 points into my health. And then on this last one, which one is it? This one. This one's great. I really need to finish this out. Rampaging Madness. When you deal damage, you gain a stack of madness. When you reach 50 stacks of madness, you gain 4,000 power, 4,000 lifesteal, and 4,000 regeneration. 10 seconds after gaining this bonus, your stacks are reset. You may only gain one stack of madness per second. So, takes 50 seconds, but every 50 seconds in a heated fight, you're getting a huge bonus. So, that's a really good one. Icewind Dale, haven't even touched. Now, power. Crit. Combat advantage is increased by 10%. It's quite a bit. You now regen stamina 5% faster. Now, it's not great, but this doesn't do us no good. So that does help. It helps our sprint. And when you're using, what the heck's it called? Gladiator Guile, it helps you even go faster. So I'll get into that here in a second. Now here's our Underdark campaign. That's when I just went. Yeah, okay, so that's where I'm at. Okay, so here's your stamina. Now, the last one, gain 10% damage versus demons. This helps you out a lot if you're, like, farming for your twisted weapons or whatnot, running your Underdark campaign. Afterwards, you got to still do a ton of work in there. I run the Skirmish Dwarven Gods constantly just for rings and AD, and I use it to check my builds a lot because I've ran it so many times. I know what my damage should usually be at. So this is good. Out of all of them, it's your best choice as a great weapon fighter. Power. Crit. Armor pin. I haven't done the rest. But lifesteal rating. Lifesteal rating. I honestly don't even understand that. It doesn't give you 400 lifesteal. It gives you 400 lifesteal rating. I'll have to look into that. 8% increased. Oh, duh. Dragon's Fury. I mean, that's a no-brainer right there. I don't even gotta look at the rest. As for your maze, you got 5% lifesteal severity, 400 combat advantage bonus, 3% faster on your action points, and when you're striking a foe, you have a chance to gain 2,000 crit for 6 seconds. Yes, please. It's like giving you a sudden ring of precision. What do they call those, actually? That's I got one. So, Ring of Rising Precision. That's like sudden precision, but they call it something else. I can't remember. I wouldn't run it anyway. I don't want a double stack of crit. I run the Brutality. These were hard, not easy to farm. It's kind of luck. This was luck. I literally got this ring the first time I ran the skirmish. And I have never gotten anything out of there since. I was so lucky. The luck was unbelievable at that point. So you get that in the Prophecy of Madness. Now, this thing's not easy to run because... Not just because of the fact that it's not always easy, but if your teammates aren't very intelligent about the skirmish, even if they have the item levels, they can still screw it up easily. So to get gold in here is not usually easy. Somehow I just got 70. I was like, oh, you know, I'll try this one out. Jumped in, just blew through it, got an orange ring, and couldn't believe it. Just unbelievable. And then I literally only ran it once, so I kept thinking it was out of the Dwarven Gods, and I kept trying to farm it there like an idiot. But yeah, that's not easy at all. So we've gone over our feats, we've gone over our powers, we've gone over our boons. Let's check out my companions. As a companion, you're going to want to be using the Bonding Runestones, Greater Bonding Runestones, whatever, the highest you can get, for sure. Now, I use... The Archon, because it just, I could make the rings and neck pieces rather easily in comparison to, I think the fire one takes something different. Now, these all need to get upgraded. This one needs to get upgraded, but this gives you a 3% crit severity bonus. Definitely you want to buy, these ones here. These are the Dancing Swords. This one I got just gives you 300 regeneration. I really... don't have much to fill in that slot. I could fill other things easily. This gives you 50% chance. Summon Companion gets 50% critical severity. You get 1%. So, yeah, why not? Named him Barbecue. He's a big old fat piggy, so check that out. Now, here's another little trick. You can actually, instead of throwing away or taking up bag space, you can start stacking your, I don't at the time, but you can put these things in here. If you don't want to throw them away and they're taking up bag space, you can put your runestones, rings, necks, and just hold them on your active companions. Pretty good and easily. Now, the Fire Archon was a really popular one. The reason I didn't go with it was just because the talisman. I didn't have one at the time. And I was going to use this one because everybody was using it, but I was like, man, I can just make the neck piece. I'll just use the other one. Basically the same. Now, your active bonus on this guy is increase your damage against targets with less than 50% health hit points by 5%. That's a good one. I'm not quite sure why I have it in this one at the time. I think it was something I was doing with regen at the time. I was checking it out. But this is definitely the better one I prefer. See what else we missed. So powers, feats, boons, companions, mounts. Now, as for mounts, I run Gladiator Guile. It's a really good one. Move faster when your stamina. So Gladiator Guile, when your stamina is above 75%, you move 15% faster. You notice that. You notice that shit immediately. When your stamina is below 25%, you gain it faster. So this, you can't go wrong here. I absolutely love this thing. I've gotten rid of it, tried to use something else, and he just feels so much slower once you get used to it. So, Protector's Camaraderie. Whenever your summoned companion attacks, you gain 3.5 of his power and defense for 10 seconds. This effect can stack up to 4 times. Now, so, when your companion's attacking, not only... See, this is why you need to use attacking companions instead of support companions. Is because of the Gladiator, or the Protector's Camaraderie. Now... If you were to use, okay, say, this is why I had it in. I was trying this. Okay, so you were to use an Apprentice Healer, and you were to use that as your Bonnie Runestones. It procs just as much, and it heals you. So it's not bad at all. The reason being that you want to run an attacking. Now, I would recommend, if you're not a high level, running an Apprentice Healer with Bonnie Runestones. They will proc constantly. And if I didn't explain what the Bonnie Runestones do, I'm sorry. You know, I make these videos, and I sometimes forget people are watching them that don't know anything about the game. When applied to a companion, when your companion activates a power, it has a chance to grant you companion's gift, which grants you 50% of companion stats for 20 seconds. So You have three of those, you get 150% of his stats. Now, it says when he uses a power. Now, this is why you can't actually use a healer, because he's using his powers. But he doesn't attack very much. So, when you get to the point you're using Protector's Camaraderie, you need them to attack, which also procs your Bonnie Runestones, procs your Protector's Camaraderie. And I have two of those stacked. Gives you from 3% to 3.5, not a lot. Then you just run a Protector's Friendship with that, 1%, same thing. Then Barbarian's Revelry is just something I have in right now. Your crit strikes heal you. I just bought this thing to look at it, really. This is what I was using. It was Berserker's Rage, so when my action points were full, you get 10% armor pen as power. That's what I was using. Now, I just swapped it out after I made this build because I'm not really going to keep my action points full very often, because as soon as I get them, I'm going to be hitting them for the slam, and then this is not ever going to be used. So this would maybe be used 30% of the time, maybe 10%. I mean, once you get your action points full, you hit slam, it does a huge AoE damage, and you just need to be doing that. So I put in right now just my Barbarian's Revelry because I've always just kind of been fond of it. But it's not necessary, and it does help you a lot at lower levels. I will give you guys that. This thing saved me so many times. I ran this with Soul Forged all the way to 70 because I didn't have anyone helping me. I didn't know what to do. So I grinded to 70 just the old-fashioned, stupid, hard way. I mean, it took forever. And by the time I got there, I still didn't have anything. But I did have this. I actually bought this polar bear because I liked it. I had no idea that they even gave you stat bonuses, and so I just happened to run across it. It helped me stay alive more. You got a lot to look through, a lot to choose from. In fact, I'm sure there's a few more added. I haven't looked much through those. The ones we are using are currently very good as they are. So as for the your gear, okay, your Dusk Assault gear is still going to be very present because you can get it from the trade bar. So if you're a VIP, which you can do, I have another video, you can do that easily just by farming AD and changing over for Zen, getting basically free VIP, which gives you your loot, not your loot boxes, they keep calling them loot boxes, I've been playing Overwatch. It gives you your enchanted keys every day, so as you're opening those, you get trade bars. As you get trade bars, you can buy this gear. And it's good gear that you don't have to farm for at all, really, if you're getting your trade bars. So, now, you want to farm for the twisted weapon, because, well, you might just need it to get the other weapons. That's the thing about this game, is that I couldn't really get the twisted weapon without having the artifact, elemental artifact weapon prior, because you need that power and damage increase. So you might need to farm this from Demogar, the demo run, just to be able to get your headhunter and all the other good stuff. So this is a very good weapon. It is becoming outdated, but nothing's outdated because you literally have to move through all these different levels to get to the higher levels. I have people that make fun of me for being item level 10,000. I could care less what other people say. The build's solid. It doesn't matter what item level you're at. Your feats, your powers, those things are solid all the time. And your gear is just something really you're constantly doing. This is what the game's about, is your gear. Is farming for your gear, farming for your items. So people sit there and make fun of other people for item level. Well, a lot of the time these people are paying for it. You know, a lot of the YouTube guys farm for it. A lot of the hardcore guys farm for it. But most of these people running around, they go watch a build and they buy it. And there's nothing wrong with that. I have no problem. You want to spend money in the game, I think it's a great game. I've invested some money, not much. Maybe $100 over a year. But I definitely don't anymore. Unless it's like a last minute VIP thing, like, oh crap, my VIP's up, I forgot to farm it, I'm broke, I just bought a new, you know, weapon enchantment. Then I might throw $10 down. But like I said, it's added up to maybe $100 over a year. So as for your weapon enchantment slot, so Your crit severity, you want to be using the Vorpal, all right? But this is actually changing to the Lightning. But I feel like as you're moving up, a Vorpal would be good until you can get to, like, a perfect Lightning and get the real chains put together on them, because they do Lightning Chain attacks and gives you a huge damage bonus. So it's good because it's constantly giving you a bonus on your damage. But if you're at, say... What am I even at on this one? So I got a regular Vorpal. So if I went to a greater, I'd probably move to the Lightning. But as for right now, I will stay at the Vorpal and not go just for the regular Lightning, because I don't think there's really enough buffs to equal out. So I got all my enchantments are rank 9. I think I have one rank 10. One rank 10. So, I mean, this is the hard part. Is just ranking your enchantments up, saving up the AD to do it. You know, getting these to mythic. I almost got this one to 99 in this last double refinement. I didn't put a lot of farming time in for the double refinement. So, next double refinement, I'm going to try to get at least two of these upgraded. I'm going to try to get my demo set. So, now all I need is the... Okay, as you're building your weapon fighter, the best is the Lost Mouth set, all right? As you're building it, as you're growing. The Lost Mouth Horn of Blasting. The Belt of Puissance. And the Lost Mouth Horde Necklace. Now that gives you the set bonus. What am I doing? Okay. So it gives you the set bonus here. Do an additional hit of weapon damage on crit strike. This got nerfed a while back. It's still very relevant if you don't have a few million AD laying around. Now, I just put out a video, in fact, on... Oh, I haven't even... See, this is what VIP gets you. Every day you get that. Purple one gives you a key. The bottom one gives you keys for the dungeons that you'll never, ever use. So let's see if I can get anything. You see, open one of these a day. 18 trade bars, right? That's you just keep stacking those until you can get that original stuff. So, and yeah, I've gotten this horse now twice. It's odd. If anybody wants one, just hit me up. You can have it for real. On Xbox, obviously, I'm on Xbox One. But if you want this horse, dude, I got one in my bank already. They're not worth anything because they're so flooded the market right now. It's pretty bad. So, and as you can see, like, I don't sit with 5 million, 10 million. Like, you see these other YouTubers, they have so many Astral Diamonds. It's like, you know, I just don't have the time most of the time. Or when I do get to a decent amount of Astral Diamonds, I tend to have to spend them on things I need. So, that's the thing right there. I'm not trying to show off how much stuff I have. I'm just building like you guys are. I put a lot of time into figuring it out, and I put a lot of time into looking into the different builds, and I noticed that I just had a... I don't know if I learned it faster, put more time into it, or what happened, but I just was helping so many people that I decided that it was time to put a video out, and that was, what, 8 months, 10 months ago? And now, thank you, I almost have 1,000 subs. I'm at, like, 800, almost 900. And that's just going to keep growing. So now this is another thing. When you get in your element, you can come buy these and you can farm these here. This is another thing about VIP. As you rank up your VIP benefits, you get... So even though I'm at the salvage, I can pull out my own salvage. So that's a good way of getting a little bit of AD. I think these dropped in price quite a bit. They used to be, I think, 5. That's actually when I stopped playing for a while, was because of all that. So, back to just the build. We got your powers. We got your feats. The one I did forget, you're probably having 5 feat points you haven't put anywhere. And that is into Student of the Sword. Your critical strikes lower your target's damage resistance to your attacks by 5% for 5 seconds. It doesn't stack. God, I wish it stacked at least 3 times. That'd be great, right? But so, that's your other 5 points. And yeah, nothing in Sentinel. Everything in Destroyer, 5 into Instigator. That's it. As for your boons, I've showed you what I have. Now, always go for the attacking ability. So, they're offering you regen or power, get the power. They're offering you lifesteal or crit, get the crit. You know, they're offering you regen or lifesteal, take the lifesteal. So, just always to be taking and dealing damage. I've showed you the companions. As for the mount bonus, I run the critical. I have defense and lifesteal. I do like to throw in the lifesteal on occasion. In fact, it does help my life a lot. The defense I can also put in because this gives me 20% power. So I get 20% of my defense as power. Cool, right? That's like, what, 400 more power and 2,000 defense instead of just 2,000 crit. So I'll mess around with that a little more. I'd recommend getting the 2,000 power, 2,000 crit. Got 110 movement speed, not 150, and I just tend to like riding the dog there. I got that out of one of the skirmishes, one of the events. This panther, you look absolutely horrible riding that thing, so I wouldn't recommend that. Your stats all into strength and dex. When you're rolling your originals, you want to get these as low as possible. And well, just whatever different title you want. Now, if you don't know about titles, these are what show up in, you earn them as you go, and then it's what's underneath your name. So it's just kind of whatever you want. I liked the blue because I like blue. So any questions, comments, concerns, just let me know in the comments below. I'm sure I'm going to have people hating that I got rid of marks. I'm sure other people are going to see the benefits of it. And it just basically, if you don't do what everybody else is doing, they get pissed off. And they start hating on you. And that's one thing I want to tell you guys about this game is don't let those people get to you. There's so many level snobs and just rude people out there. But you know what? There's just as many good people. They just don't usually turn their mics on. So if you turn your mic on and you're just in a good mood and you just help people out, they'll eventually usually turn their mics on. And usually only the decent people will if they had them off. Usually that, you know, the jerk-offs constantly have theirs on. So. Like I said, questions, comments, concerns, just leave below. I hope this helps you guys out. And I will let you know on the updated gear very soon as I farm it. I will put it out immediately for you guys. So thank you for watching and enjoy the rest of your day.